Hello and welcome to my next lecture, where I'll be discussing if function with minimum and maximum. We'll be nesting if with minimum and we'll be nesting if with maximum. Okay, I'll just share my screen and we'll show you the data. So these are the data points where we'll be learning maximum and minimum function. This is the data which I have collected from the most recent Olympic, and since India has got gold. So I just thought of discussing this data and letting you know the maximum and minimum with if. So my aim is, say for example, Neeraj Chopra had three attempts. Okay, so I want to know what is his minimum, javelin throw result, and what is his maximum. Same for Nadeem, Arshad, Weber, Julian. Okay. If you want to obtain the minimum and maximum throughout this result, from this result, this is pretty easy. Like say, for example, you want minimum of these results, then you'll have 76.79, which is of Neeraj Chopra only, which he did in the third attempt. If you want the maximum, okay. If you want the maximum, you can just apply maximum formula and you'll get 87.58, which is of Neeraj Chopra only. So the minimum and maximum from these data points, it is for Neeraj Chopra. But what if like I want only for Weber Julian and not for others? So if I select over Weber Julian, I want his minimum throw to be pasted over here and his maximum throw to be here. Maximum over here and minimum over here. So how do I do that? Okay, I'll type in max. Okay. Now since it's a condition based, like say for example I want the maximum result only for the one which has been selected here in the I2, so I'll click on if. Okay, what will be the logical test if these all of these FNF4? I'll just absolute this, because when I just drag and drop the formula, I want the range to remain the same. Okay, so if this is equals to I2, right? If this is equals to, like, any of the data collected from this table is equals to this. So what I'll do, I'll click on over here. I'll again absolute this, because I don't want this to change when I drag and drop. Okay. If this is equals to this, I want the maximum out of this, right? So I'll get the maximum. I'll again absolute this and we'll close the parenthesis for maximum, then close the parenthesis for if, sorry, first if and then maximum. And after the formula is written, do not press enter, press control shift and enter. Okay, control shift and enter. And you can just drag and drop. You can come over here and change it to minimum. And again, control shift enter, you'll get, I did this for both of them. I'll come over here, I'll type in minimum, control shift enter, I'll get the minimum data, right? So this is the maximum throw for Weber Julian, 85.3 and 77.9. Let's just check. Weber Julian, 77.9 is the minimum, 85.3 is the maximum. Now I want this from Neeraj Chopra. And yeah, 87.58 maximum. 87.58 was the maximum over this data, and he has got gold as well. This is how you find minimum and maximum on the basis of a condition, right? So we have learned how you can work on condition based and or you can work with nested ifs. Okay, how you can find the minimum and maximum using if. So these are a couple of very, very important topics which I have discussed in the previous lectures and in this lecture as well. So I'd request you to go and practice all of them. In the coming section, we'll be learning count if, sum if. These are again two very important if topics. And lastly, we'll be learning if error. Say for example, if my formula is encountering an error, what should be the outcome? So these are a couple of lectures which will be coming up. And till then, please go through this lecture, practice hard. And if any question comes up, do let me know in the comment section. Okay, thank you. And have a very good day. Bye-bye.